X-ray machine.
Okay, let me just address the 2 points. First, on the payment, so we're selling this one first to clinics, and then the second at-home version will be sold to small PHCs, Anganwadis, midwives, and then that price point will be lower than this, and the mother
still... How different are the two products?
They're quite different. The technology is the same. The other one will be non-electric. Right. It'll last longer. It's not for...
So the other one doesn't have a heater?
It has a heater, but a heater uses boiling water. Rather than electricity.
So you don't need that contraption to be carried?
There will be a separate contraption into which you put boiling water.
Okay.
So the mother is not paying for the device. Even now,
this is a B2B2C product, and that's a B2C product.
Yes.
That's also not B2C. That still has to go to a different business.
It still doesn't go, yeah. So the thing is, the mother is not buying the product. She's paying it for use. It's a rental model.
Okay.
So the cost is very low. Even now, a $20,000 incubator, how much does a mother pay for it?
She's paying the hospital. She's paying the medical center.
Right. Yes.
It's medical equipment more than consumer equipment.
On rent, yeah.
It's not something that I bring home, but it's something that is used at the primary health center or used to transport a baby from point A to point B.
Yeah.
So product A is being sold, but product B will be rented, you're saying?
Will be?
Will be on hire. The second product, this product.
That will be sold to a clinic. It's sold to somebody, but the mother is not buying it. The mother's not buying this, the mother's not buying that.
Okay. Here's my overall. I think you guys set up to solve the problem, and I think you've done a damn good job on the technology side.
Thank you.
But the bigger problem is how do you get this distribution to places that you really want to get it into? And I'm a little concerned that you've left it to large, guys who have absolutely no interest in getting it there and no ability to get it there.
So let me address that. So one is that we've made it very clear in that this distribution partnership with GE, it's non-exclusive. We've told them, and we're setting a price point for them. They cannot sell it above that price point. And then we are working with local distributors in India who have special, like Novartis, Pharmax, who have special programs to get to rural areas, all the way down to tier 5, rural areas, and they distribute the pharmaceutical and medical devices there. So we're partnering with them, and we're doing direct sales. And third is we're working with the government to go through these programs.
I think that's
to
the
get
issue, right? When you're trying to replace an equipment somebody has sold for 10 lakhs, that guy's made a big commission on it. And you're going to replace it with equipment for 10,000, that guy's not going to make very much money on it. So you've got to find somebody else who wants to get into that space and not the existing channel. So I think that's where the creativity has to come. In addition to the creativity you've shown out here, this is laudable. Mm-hmm. But I think your real challenge is going to come in the monetization and how you're able to get 100,000 of these out as opposed to just 500 or 1,000 because you're replacing some other equipment.
And distribution, like Novartis has started a new arm for rural distribution just 2 years ago. That's mission is to do just this. And we're partnering with them to sell this product and other products like
Mahesh's point is also that this has a very narrow use case in terms of rural India. How do you react to that point, this narrow use case point?
Saying that this...
You want to elaborate on that point?
So my issue is that, like you said, this is either going to a place which has some kind of baby care facilities already, or like you said, it's going to be used in transporting a baby from one PHC to a larger hospital, going from a taluk, village to a taluk.
So your point is that this can be used alone without an incubator being there at all.
So you're saying that it's a narrow use case and that we're not going to reach scale.
Is it a replacement to an incubator or is it an add-on?
No, it's not. So it can be used as an in-clinic warning device and as for transport. And another thing that...
So it can be used as a replacement without any incubator facilities at all?
Not a complete replacement. As I said, some babies will require, oxygen control and humidity, which this won't offer.
Right. My only point is if you get the distribution and pricing right, the beauty of this business is that it's global. And you can be all across the damn planet.
Right.
You can be in sub-Saharan Africa, you can be in the middle of Bangladesh, you can be anywhere. And therefore, I think it's a huge market opportunity if you get it right. And I think that's why I'm struggling to see what's taken so long to get the finance right. And maybe I need to spend more time.
I suspect it's not a technology problem. I suspect the problem that you haven't cracked yet is really being able to get it to that last mile where you want to get it, where you haven't found the via media to get it there. And so I think giving it up, giving the problem to another company is not going to solve it because that's not their mission. Their mission isn't what you set out to solve. Their mission is sales of large, high-value equipment.
Yeah, so one thing, it's taken us a while because this is a medical product, which is the development cycle is always much longer. There's regulatory constraints. You have to do clinical trials, all these things. And we want to stick with our core competency, which is the design, understanding the user, making these innovative low-cost products rather than, we want to keep that focus rather than...
So actually that worries me, because you'll make all these cool products, but they will not get to the baby that it needs to get to because, to really make the change happen, you also have to have the core competency of making sure that you're able to make that device reach the baby where it is. You can't outsource that to somebody else. Nobody else has a core company.
I wouldn't say we're outsourcing. I'd say we're partnering with the right people who have aligned missions.
It's a distributor. You're saying you sell it. If he doesn't sell it, he's selling 50 other things, and you're the 51st thing he's selling. His life and death doesn't depend on this product.
Perfect. We're running out of time. Fair enough. So use score sheet time. There are some views on the distribution model. Sasha, what are your views on the technology as opposed to the model, the distributor model?
I think the technology is great.
Okay.
It's very innovative.
Right, fantastic. Right. And you think the go-to-market strategy is in question?
That's right.
Okay. Mahesh?
So, I think the technology is really cool. I wonder if it is, you know, patentable. I mean, can you patent a wax? I'm not so sure. I mean, I think you can patent a particular use or something out there.
Fair.
So, you know, my other worry is if it's successful, some dude in China is going to make it for 1/10 the price. And if he figures out distribution, we can be a wonderful design studio, but we've not made the impact that we want to make. Make the impact.
Right. You want to react to that finally? That patent point? What is being patented? The use case or the material?
It's a patent on not the specific material, but using this material for warming of humans. And I do agree because we also know that a patent at the end of the day is a piece of paper. Even if we have it and legally it's ours, it's not going to stop someone from China or even India or anywhere making a knockoff. So that's why with our partners, we want to make sure that we flood the market, we get it out, and government partnerships are going to be huge there, getting out to the right people and getting the regulatory mark.
Right.
The
CE mark. Last question, would you agree with the panel that getting to the last mile is your biggest challenge right now?
I'd say, yeah, it's definitely one of our biggest challenges.
Okay, great. It's score time. Sasha, time to dig into those scores and come out with your score sheet. Eight, seven.
Thank you.
Just once again, Sasha, just put it up a little high.
I want to judge a beauty contest after this.
Fantastic. It's been great fun hosting this contest, and I'm very happy to announce that we have a winner. Can I invite the team from Embrace Global onto stage?